My talk is about Russian contribution to the Postgres, because not everybody knows how Russians what Russians did for Postgres, and we made several slides to illustrate that how we participated in the Postgres community. Okay, I myself started using Postgres in. Okay, very interesting colors. That color's supposed to be black. Okay, doesn't matter. Okay. Oops. Okay, so you see the first slide is about Russians and Postgres. Okay, I started using Postgres in 1995, and my first contribution to the Postgres was adding locale support to PostgreSQL. Maybe you don't know, but original Postgres was developed by American people and Canadian American people, and they did not bother about all our characters. And I discovered it and decided to fix it. So I made the first patch, and it was committed. That time it was very easy to commit, and since that, all European users and start using Postgres. So I believe that this was my the most important contribution, because 21 years ago I was maybe there were maybe one or two people in Russia who use Postgres, and not much in Europe. And now I travel in Europe and see how many Postgres users, and Postgres still develops and becomes very popular, especially in Russia, thanks for the sanctions. Yes. So here is my little illustration of the project I participated with all my colleagues, so you can recognize JSONB, HStore, Gene, GIST, SPGIST, many projects we developed. This is a slide I prepared for the celebration of 20 years of PostgreSQL, and now we constantly improve it. So this is a functionality, and this is time. The green color show the start of the project. Do you know that the project starts from the version 6.0? Do you know why? Postgres is a 6.0, the first version. It becomes because we want to show the connection with the first version of Postgres. Postgres 1, Postgres 2, Postgres 3, 5, and Postgres 5 was Postgres 95. So PostgreSQL starts from Postgres 6. And the first Russian patch. See, the first Russian patch was committed 2 weeks after the starting the project. It was a patch by Mikheyev, Vadim Mikheyev. So this is a first Russian patch. My patch was about internationalization. Then we start, you see, introduced wall, write ahead log, you know what it is. MVCC, triggers, transaction isolation. Then we started developing GIST. GIST was very interesting project, because since this project we realized that extensibility of Postgres is the main feature, the main advantage of Postgres. And we start using the, we create Gene, HStore, you see the full text search we also developed. So red line is a Russian contribution. And we developed KNN GIST. KNN GIST is a hidden treasure of PostgreSQL. Not everybody knows about this, but please remember it and read the documentation, because KNN is very, very interesting feature. I'm very proud for this rich feature. It can accelerate your queries like 1,000 times, not just 10%, 20%, but 1,000 times. So KNN is very powerful. And SPGIST, then you see the In 2012, JSON was introduced, and that time we already got a lot of requests to improve our H store, to add support for the arrays, for the objects. And after JSON was introduced, I was a bit disappointed, because JSON is just a text. It's not usable for the really working. It's usable for storing. Yeah, but I believe that Postgres is good database, and it is possible to work with the non-structural data very efficiently. So we started working on the improving of HStore, and this project finished as a JSONB. So we made a JSONB, and you know that JSONB is not just a binary JSON. JSONB means better JSON. And after that, we made an extension method as an extension. So we can create access method as extension and generic val. This is also very important. It adds ability to create extension method as a extension access method, new access method, as extension. So you don't need to ask core team to commit your patch. You can create your own and use it. And this is because we have API for access method and generic val. And the first demonstration of this feature was BloomIndex, already said, and RoomIndex. And the question was about the whiskey. The problem is that we started from gin, then room, vodka. We can't, you know, the degree, you know, should be go up. So maybe the last will be like spirit. Yeah, but we reserved it for future. And
we have names in France if you want. We have lots of names if you want.
You have to, to drink Calva.
Yeah, Calva.
Unfortunately, I don't drink at all. Alcohol.
We do.
Yeah, you do. Yeah. So now we 2 years ago we start a very interesting project like the PG Python. If you know this, PG Python is a very efficient partitioning. It's not like vanilla partitioning, but it's much more powerful. It has PG Python. Remember it. We started because we tired to wait when community will introduce something about partitioning. But when it happens that when we start and got some first results, community wake up and start working on declarative partitioning. So now we have very interesting situation. Community version has a very good declarative partitioning, but that declarative partitioning use old partitioning technology. So it's slow. We hope that in new version it will be fixed somehow. But with PG-Passman, we have a functional interface, but it's very powerful because it has very good pruning technology. So if you want to have a very fast partitioning right now, I recommend you use PG-Passman. If you are happy with the current partitioning, it's so-so, so you can wait for the next version. But I can't promise that it will be fast in the new version. We made PG Passman specially for the practical needs of our customers, and we support it, so don't afraid to use it. It is very, very powerful, PG Passman. You can find it on our GitHub. It is available also from the community repositories. Yeah, we intend to support vanilla partitioning, so our developers will participate in the improving of partitioning in community projects. So Postgres has to be distributed database if we want to survive in the future. Yes? Many, many years we thought about cluster of Postgres. We're a bit tired to wait from the community. So we start our project. We start multi-master. Multimaster, sharding, and we have already a commercial version of Enterprise, Postgres Pro Enterprise. It has all this stuff inside. We will certainly try to push it back to the community, but it is very, very complicated process. It may take like several years. We already try to put some patches for distributed transaction manager, push back to community, but community is too conservative. Do you remember how we made a Windows port? People start asking us about Windows many, many years ago, but community always said, oh, Windows is nothing. After Windows ports becomes a reality, Postgres becomes very popular. You remember about the replication. People said that we don't need replication in Postgres. This is external tools, external utility. But yes, after several years of discussions, we got replication. Now we have logical replication. So I hope that community somehow will agree that we need clustering, we need a multi-master inside, built in. Yeah, so our company decided to start working on multi-master to demonstrate that it is possible. And now we have we are on the point where all our multi-master testing a very big corporation in Russia. And after we polish this multi-master, we'll try to push to the community. For now, if you are interested in the multi-master, you can make a contract with our company. We'll be very happy to work with you. Our enterprise version contains not just multi-master, but also 64-bit transaction ID. Do you know about the wraparound of transaction? This is a really big problem for the big projects. Yes. So we decided to have a 64-bit transaction. And we made a patch for the Postgres, and now our customers don't bother about the wraparound. So this is also a very good feature. Also, we will be happy to push back to the community. But also, this is a patch which touched so many places of Postgres, and community does not have resources to review all these patches. This is a big problem that our community actually changes. When we start working with Postgres, community was very powerful because all developers were freelance developers. I was a freelance developer and I was a part of community. But now we have the situation when all major contributors like me, we work on some companies, some Postgres companies. And even we, I and Theodore and Alexander, we 3 years ago organized the commercial company. That means that community now is just developers, users. But actually there was not so many core, major contributors. And our resources are a bit limited because we are very busy with working with our customers. We are commercial companies. We have to work with customers. We have to answer to their requirements. But there is a community. And community needs more people who can review. So this is very important to have independent reviewers, independent developers. But unfortunately, we have no resources for this. I understand. You know how difficult to find good developer in France, in Russia. We know it's very difficult. We have to work on education of people. So we have to write some books, courses, we teach students in universities. Then, after several years, we can have some good young people who can work for the community. I know that some of you are already working in university. You have some books, yes. We in Russia started teaching computer science students in Moscow University, we have a course Hacking Postgres. So our developers teaching students how to work with, not how to use Postgres, but how to develop Postgres. This is very important. And All our lectures are freely available, so you can use it. You can invite us to give a talks about the internals, how to program, and so on. So we have several books already. We can also, it's also available for free. If you want to translate it, it's also doable, no problem. My idea is to create sort of collaboration between communities. So you know that months ago, I calculated the number of subscribers in the Postgres mailing list. The Postgres mailing list contains like 70,000 of subscribers, users. This is nothing, because real number of users much, much, much more bigger. And you know because of, for example, I know because in Russia we have thousands of users. Our conferences are very big. We have like 500 users, 600 people coming. We have many conferences in the whole year, meetups, very popular. But we have just 20 Russian users in the mailing list. I think the same situation with friends. So you subscribe to maybe 50 friends people. No, I see the French names in the mailing list regular, not so much. And because there are several reasons, because English language is not our native language. We are not very good with this. We can't write long threads, discussions, and so on. Yes, and a new generation of people don't like mailing list. It's not very convenient, because if you want to subscribe, in mailing list, it's impossible to subscribe to one thread. If you're interested in one topic, you should subscribe to the hackers. Then you get a lot of emails every day, and you lost. So if you know some good software for the forum should be, of course, support Postgres. So maybe it's time to create some forum for our communities. And we can attract more young people. This is a question to the organizers of Friends community. And we also, Russian community, we're open for collaboration. We can work together, no problem. We have very good and rich history of collaboration between Russia and France, you know. And, okay. Something happens. Okay, so we have sharding, we have XTM, and we have vodka. Vodka, as Alexander said, is our dream. We made a prototype. We understand that it's possible to do, but no power, no resources. And the summary about the Russians in Postgres, it's not limited by development. Do you know that Postgres logo, elephant? It was made by Russians. You know the name Slonik? Slonik is a Russian name for elephant, for small elephant. So logo was made by Russians. I wrote special blog post about this. I made an investigation. There are so many, many links to the very old version of website of Postgres. Yeah, so this is proved. And two generations of PostgreSQL.org was made by Russians. Two generations, not the last, but in the past. And this is what we did. It's okay. And the Russian community is one of the biggest community. Our conference, as I said, had more than 600 people. Yes. And this year we have two big conferences, pgconf.ru and pgday. Pgconf in the winter in Moscow and pgday in St. Petersburg in summer. So we have sessions at all big Russian conferences. We have special Postgres sessions. We have meetups. Every month we have some big meetup, like hundreds of people. We have chats. on PGSQL, on Telegram, on Facebook. We have more than 2,000 now, much more people. We have mailing list. I said it's very low traffic. People don't like mailing list. Yes, and we have forum, which is not very, it's very old. It's not very interesting to us. So we want to find a way how to organize the forum. Maybe European forum. Why not? Yeah, but I just don't know the good forum software, which will be looks very good, interesting for the young people, some, you know, and supported by Postgres. So to use Postgres. And our company, we say that we are Postgres professional, we are Russian vendor of Postgres. What does it mean? It means that we provide all kinds of support to our customers. Development, consulting, support, and so on. And we, of course, we are a commercial company, but we are part of international community. So we push back, you see, for 9.6, we committed 65 patches, for example. The last 10 versions, Postgres 10, has 20 developers from our companies in the acknowledgement list, and about 100 of patches. Postgres 11 will be even more interesting, because for Postgres 11, we are working on improving JSONB support. Do you know about, I made a talk in Warsaw about SQL JSON. So we are working on SQL JSON in Postgres. So it will be a very, very interesting project. Another project is JSONB compression. We also hope to commit to the Postgres 11. We say we have Postgres Professional. We support community Postgres. We have our distribution Postgres Professional. We have a regulation in Russia that if you work with the personal data, you have to use special version of software, certified. I don't know how about this in France. But in Russia, we have to certify it. So we made our special patches, security patches for Postgres. And we have a certified version, which is commercial, and we sell it, the license. Our big corporations, they use Oracle and SQL Server. They don't want to have a free version. They want to have enterprise version. So we have enterprise version, which has many, many interesting enterprise features. Like I said, compression. We have compression, 64-bit transaction. We have multi-master. We have autonomous transactions and many, many. On our website, we have a list of enterprise features. We develop custom extensions for our customers. So if you are looking for the new feature, new functionality of Postgres, you can ask us. We can do for you this development. We provide support, consulting, audit, and teaching. We have a Russian documentation. By the way, this is we learned from the French community. Because the French community, okay, French community was the first who translated documentation English to French. And we asked people from community how to do this, and we managed to make our Russian version now. Yes. We have a DBA 1, DBA 2 development training courses, and as I said, Hacking Postgres. Hacking Postgres is a very interesting project. So, let's finish. I invite all of you to the pgconf.ru, to Russia, February 5, 7. Real winter, real Russian people, vodka, very interesting topics, many, many people. Just you will have a very good opportunity to see the people. Try real vodka, give a talk. The speakers supported. We support speakers, so we pay for the travel, for accommodation, your call for paper already opened, so submit your talks. Yes. And this year, the conference will be held in the Lomonosov Moscow State University. The big, very historical places, very interesting auditorium, like amphitheater. Just imagine, you know. So you are welcome to the Russia. And thanks. This is our new slogan, PostgreSQL Universal Database. That means that we are looking for new Postgres, which support all kinds of workloads, not just OLTP, but all up web workload. And we are working on this. Okay, thank you for the attention. We'll be right back.